Welcome back. My name is Marek. I'm a software engineer at SourceGraph, and we're going to talk about some features that make your searches and your search results in SourceGraph even more useful. First off, if you find yourself running the same particular searches frequently, you can save them so that you can quickly run those searches again. You have two ways to do this: search contexts and search snippets. First off, search contexts. Search contexts are a way of defining a particular set of repos or files that you want to search in. If you're regularly searching within particular groups of repos, for example, only your own team's repos, or only front-end or back-end repos, search contexts are the way to do that. To access search contexts, click on the context selector on the left-hand side of the search bar. You can go to Manage Contexts, where you can create or edit your context. To switch between the contexts to use them, just click on that context in the dropdown. Next are search snippets. Setting up a search snippet will create a one-click link on the bottom left of the search filter menu. Once you have it set up, it allows you to add it to your query with just one click. This is useful if you want to keep a commonly used set of filters that you want to apply to your searches, for example. Search snippets are defined in your SourceGraph settings. Add an entry called search.scopes with a name for your snippet and a search query fragment as the value. Now, to use the snippet, find it at the bottom of the sidebar of the search results page. Click on the snippet to add that search query fragment to your current search. Next, exporting search results. You may want to export your search results into a spreadsheet or another tool. To do this, first enable the search export extension if it's not already enabled for your instance. Now, on any search results page, you can click on Export Search Results, which produces a CSV file containing the results. SourceGraph search results are meant to be shared. Whether you're sharing a link with a colleague, or using a link to facilitate pair programming, or even including a link in your internal documentation, SourceGraph is better when used together. To link to content in SourceGraph, copy the URL in the browser bar and share it. That will link to the same page for anyone who has access to your SourceGraph instance. When you link directly to a file in SourceGraph, by default, it'll show the latest version on that branch, but you can instead link to the exact commit that you're looking at. You can do that by clicking the permalink button in the top right of the screen below the search bar. This will update the page URL to be a permalink that contains the current commit so that you can now copy paste it. Next, dynamic filters. On the search results page, at the top left, you'll notice dynamic suggestions for filters based on the results that you're looking at. These dynamic filters are a quick way to narrow down your search. The select filter allows you to group results if you want to know which files or even which repos contain matches. To see a list of files containing matches, use select file. In the results, now we're looking at a list of matching files. To see the list of repos that contain matches, use select repo. Here, in this example, we're seeing a list of repos on the result page. These are repos where there's at least one match in any file in that repo. This is really useful if you want to find all repos which contain a particular dependency, for example. So that was an overview of a few of SourceGraph's search features and search filters, which help you make the most of your searches and to narrow down and refine your search results.